Okay, so sending and receiving money. First, let's talk about receiving money. For this, just to be simple, I'm going to jump back over to my personal account. So I'm going to hit log out up here, and then I'm going to do log in. I'm going to switch to my personal one. And remember, your login is your email address. Okay, so there's a weird thing happening right here, and I'm gonna point it out. So you'll notice that everything looks different now. The reason is the way we were looking at our overview page, which is what I'm on now, the way we were looking at that before is the new way. This is what I was talking about with they change the layout every now and then, and they're right in the middle of changing it again. So they're kind of alternating me between the new way and the old way. So now I'm seeing the old layout for this. You probably won't see this at all if you're new to PayPal. They're probably just going to start you up on the new way. But somewhere there's a way where I can switch it to show me the new way. It's okay though, right? It's all the same stuff. So let's talk about receiving money. So what you're going to want to do is if someone wants to send you money to your account, you don't really have to do anything on our side. All you have to do is tell them that email address that you used. So you can just say, PayPal me, blah, 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 a certain amount of money, and then they can do it. And what they would do is they would go into the send money button, which let's just do that. They would type in your email address and then the amount. And then they would say, what are you sending money for? I'm paying for goods or services, or I'm sending money to family or friends. And this is where things get tricky. I mean, really, they should be honest about this. But to be honest with you, I always click I'm sending money to family or friends because watch this. If I put in an email address here, and then I say $100. And if I say I'm paying for goods or services, it says, so in this case, I'm sending money to the person, right? And it says $0 for me, which means I'm gonna send them $100. But what they're gonna get is actually probably about $95 or somewhere around there because PayPal's going to take a couple bucks. So, but if they click I'm sending money to family or friends, all that money goes to them or to you. So, it's kind of, I don't know. I don't know if there's a, legal thing here, but if you don't know or care, just click just tell them to click I'm sending money to family or friends. Now when you send money, you can do the same thing. You would just go to send money, you would type in the person you're sending it to, the amount, and then what it's for. If you're sending money to family or friends, you would say I'm sending money to family or friends. If you're buying something, technically you should click this, but I always click this. Yeah, and then you say continue. And there's one more confirmation page. And it says, you are sending money to this person. You are sending this much. This is how much PayPal is going to charge, which because we're sending it to family and friends, it's zero. They will receive this much. Payment method, PayPal balances. Now, this is important. This is where we want it to come from. We want it to come from our PayPal balance. That means all of this money, this $100, is going to come out of the money we have in our PayPal account. If we don't have $100 in our PayPal account, this is going to say that it's going to come from our credit card that we have on file with PayPal. And I can manually do that. I can change it here and say, pull that money from my bank or something. So by clicking on change, it says funding options. It can either come from my PayPal balance or I can say, pull it from my bank account. I'm going to say cancel on that because you tend to not want to do that. It takes a lot longer for one, and there might be more fees associated with it. Hopefully we can always pull it from the balance of our PayPal account because that's what we want. We want our money to come out of our PayPal balance because it's faster and there's no additional fees for doing it. That's why it's always good to have some money in your PayPal account because when you need to send someone money, you've got some in there and you can avoid those little fees. Then this is the email that the person you're sending the money to will get. I like to put a little message here. Think of it like the memo of a check. Just kind of say what it's for, just so that you have a record that I'm sending you this $100 for that thing that we agreed on. And then there's a record that you paid them money for that thing, just in case. So, you know, just write for private guitar lesson, you know, or whatever, whatever it's for. And then we click send money and then it's gone. And it if you're sending to another PayPal account, it should be pretty much instantaneous. It'll show up pretty fast for them and it will be deducted from your account instantaneously as well at the same time. So there you go. Sending money and receiving money. The simple way, there are a lot of ways to do that. That's kind of what this whole thing is about. But the simple way is you can send money by just going to the send money, and you have to know what PayPal email address they use. And you can receive money by just having people know what email address you use for PayPal and just tell them send me money that way. Now, there are a lot more interesting ways to do it, right? We can invoice people. We can make web links that will prompt people to pay us money for a product. We can do tons more stuff, which is what we're going to start talking about now. This is the kind of bare bones, simple way. So up next, we're going to talk about creating web links for products and services that we offer so that somebody could pay on a website or even just right through an email. Could pay us money for a thing. So let's jump into that next.